Yardy har, me hearties, and welcome to another Pirate Survival episode. And as you can see, I've done some modification to the pig. I'm gonna call it that. Maybe I'll try some other color scheme on it. And let's do that right now, actually. So I think if I do this, I should be able to. There we go. So you can see that these guys now have, I have a grinder and a welder. The both of them have a merge block in the bottom. So if we do connect this up again, we just fly up to it. We turn on the merge block and it's gonna snap on. In a second now. There we go. And once we've done that, we have to turn on the connectors and then lock them. Because if we don't, if we leave the connectors turned on when unmerging, the connectors can still like try to keep it in place while the merging block is trying to push it away from the ship, and bad stuff happens, namely explosions, a lot of explosions. So let's unmerge that for now, and we'll move this guy back and we'll try a new color scheme. I heard green in the comments, so let's try the greens. So there we go, it looks better. The pink was cool, but this just, it kind of looks better. I gotta be honest about that. I like the greens in this game. It looks good. So what I want to do now is I want to build a new battleship, because I want to build another battleship which is going to be bigger and better. But first of all, I need a ship to capture, and I don't have anything to capture it with, and this guy isn't going to capture any ships. So we need to build something that can, and we're going to use a new strategy. So this is a pretty old strategy, I would say. It is the tank it out, just see if we can build like a heavy front line that can just soak up all the Gatling turrets while we ourselves respond with plenty. So obviously beauty is going to be the most important feature of this ship here. And so yeah, just prepare to see the most beautiful ship that you could ever imagine. As you can see on the start here, it's going to be fabulously beautiful. Oh yeah, did I mention that we're making this like 3 layers thick? I didn't? Oh well, that's kind of the point. It's gonna be 3 layers thick. And it's gonna protect us. Maybe. It's a theory! Also, I do realize that I am using light armor blocks, and that is actually intended, because the heavy armor blocks, crazy as it may seem, aren't actually that good as armor, like compared to light armor. And what I mean by that is that if you have a layer of heavy armor, or if you have a layer of light armor and you get hit by a rocket, that light armor layer is going to be destroyed. But if you have a heavy armor layer, it's still going to be destroyed. So it doesn't really matter if you're hit by a rocket, it's going to destroy a big area whether or not you're using heavy armor, at least for the small ships, unless you're using many, many amounts of armor. So I think that's gonna be fine. We have the tubes. The tubes. There and there. Maybe we can put them there and there. There and there. Remove you. And you. And put the conveyors here. And connect them in the center. There and there. Perfectamundo. It's now that we need the weld song. Weldy weld, weldy weld to, weldy 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 weld, weldy weld to, weldy weldy weld, weldy weld, 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 weldy weld. They're not rotated the same. pretend we're not seeing... Oh, that's not gonna work. I have to replace all of them. How can I get this close without dying? This is awesome. He says and dies. No, there, I... His mining carriager is... not going to hit me. That's nice. At least I have that going for me. I mean, which is nice. So I can put down one more camera. Camera. Ooh, camera. This is going to be the protected camera. And these are the backup cameras. And then we'll have more cameras. The entire phrase will be cameras. So we get the protection of the guns. The guns. They need to be protected. Efficient block placement. I've dreamed of being able to do that in survival, and I was now able to do that. I am a very, very happy man. What? Did I just have the exact amount of steel plates again? Wow, that's awesome. No. That wasn't close. Wasn't close at all. This is the dangerous place. But I made it. So let's place them there. And there, maybe that's a good idea. More small containers. Because they fit. So close. The manliest squeak ever. And there we go. There we have the big power source. We can go grab some uranium already so we have power inside him. Ura! Ura! I want large thrusters. Why? Because I can. What do you mean too many large thrusters? There can never be too many large thrusters. Are you crazy? Are you crazy? Yes, you are. Nerjanja! Large steel tubes being needed for the smallest thruster. Taking up all the storage space. You know what would be really nice to have? Like a scaffolding block that all the blocks required but one. Like, it only required one scaffolding block, and it is the block that you use to place it. So all you need to carry around when you want to build a ship is this scaffold block that builds the little frame you see in front of you. We'll see more of soon. These frames will all require just one scaffolding block, and that will make it easier to build. It's like a coin slot. Oh, that's nice. Maybe we want to use that for the parking, actually. Just build a small ship that has... These coin slots that you just shove the grinders in. That would be cool with landing gears in the back. Does that sound like a cool idea? That kind of sounds like a cool idea. Go all there. I think I need a safety on that thing. I kind of feel like I should be able to place blocks here, though I am 100% sure that they will explode. Here, 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 here. Here? Here. I do have a mod called Pirate Narrow Ammo, Pirate Ammo, so it's replaced with another just prized ammo. Because the other one needed magnesium, which... none of the ships actually have, because magnesium is only used for making ammo. So you would quickly run out of ammo if you're trying to just live off ships. So let's take a look. Wow, it's pretty. No, it's not. Looks like... I don't even know. Yeah, and then we can put a cockpit in there. And then thrusters behind that, and that would become a ship. And grab an axis from there by doing this. Blink, 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 blink. Yep, let's do that. What do you require? You require two motors or gyro. God dang it. The small ship requires the same amount of motors that the large one does. What's this? It should require like 40 motors. It's madness. How am I alive? How?
So we could get inside of this guy now.
Oh, what a beautiful view we have. Cameras. View. So we have all the cameras. From all the views. And then we have all the guns. But hopefully that middle camera will survive. Ooh, now do we place them side by side or on top of each other? I like on top of each other. That sounds cooler. Do you know what I can't do with this ship? Access the cockpits. Like, at all. There I can access. That will be my access point from now on. Amazing. This looks horrible. It looks like a stamp. There we go. And then we have some red. Because red is nice. It's we'll make a target. Yeah. Nope. That's wrong.
Middle. There we go. Now they can't miss us.
You did ask for it. Now you're getting it. It's a juicer called Uranium Potato. Wait, it doesn't work here? Oh yes, it does. He wanted to have a blue and black uranium symbol. So here he gets it. Could make the Zelda symbol though. We wanted, but that's misshapen or it's misplaced. There we go. That looks nice. Can we do that? That doesn't look I'd like to change the color of the thrusters, but I'm not familiar with the mod packs. Does the mod packs change it for all thrusters, or does it just change it for like a specific thruster that is placed, that it's called a red thruster? I don't know. If you do know, tell me in the comment section below, and you will be rewarded with honor. Or something, I don't know. I don't have anything to reward you with, I'm sorry. I can't weld that. Okay, fine. I'll not weld that. Shape here. No, I knew it! I knew it! I knew that that would happen, so let's do that. Bum. Let's grab that. I don't want the thruster to paint with. So, there we go, guys. Let's see us quickly here. Go inside, take a look through the camera, see so that all the bullets will fly. Yes, they will. See through the other guys as well. Nice. And we have 5,000 something bullets. And we can go out of this guy and do a third person here. Select something else so we don't accidentally shoot our base. Let's see what he... Wow. I did not expect him to be maneuverable at all. Even though I have large thrusters in all directions. And he's not overloading. And all I have is two gyroscopes. And this guy is quite big for at least what I usually do when I do a small ship. So anyway, let's fly out and take a look at the monstrosity that we have created. It's not a monstrosity because it's so big or because it has so many guns. It's because it looks... Quite frankly, it looks kind of horrible. And I shall admit to that. But anyway, we have the front here. It has the diamond shape, kind of. What is... No, that's an eye.
Illuminati!
Illuminati! Half-Life 3 confirmed. Everything else. No, it's not an eye. Maybe it should have been sideways, actually. It's to go with the thrusters on the back, which are also actually vertical. So it is vertical in this shape, though otherwise it is pretty symmetrical. We have the blue things here. And here, and all the sides, we have the blue wrapping. It's kind of like a Christmas present wrapping thing. No idea. I think the coloring turned out, like, really nice. The ship itself looks like a short stamp. I might have said this before, but you may be thinking of something else. I think we'll call him Tank. Just Tank. Because that's what he is made for. He has all the layers of armor. Okladoki, guys, so there we go. Sadly, I can't give you a fight of this right now. Because just nothing's popping up. There was a military escort, but they do have the rocket launchers, and I'm fairly confident that this will not survive a rocket launch. Actually, I'm pretty confident that if it hits the front, it might even break my cockpit. So I think I'm not gonna go for the military ships until I have a large ship of my own, which is kind of what I want to capture a military ship for. So, well, maybe if I can add a second layer of heavy armor or something in the front, I might go for that. Maybe I'll change up the first layer for heavy armor, see if that actually helps against the rockets. But I don't think so. Sadly, I don't have time for that right now. If you have any tips or tricks to help against the rocket turrets, then feel free to leave them in the comment section below. If you have anything on your heart whatsoever, feel free to leave them in the comments as well. And I shall see you, hello, next time.